Hello everyone, I welcome you all to join us in celebrating Ashok Leyland completing 70 impactful years of innovation, transformation and serving the nation. My name is Paloma Rao and I will be taking you all through a very special journey. A journey that began right here in Chennai in 1948 and went on to revolutionize the country's automobile industry, moving the country and the economy forward. So let's take a walk down memory lane through the decades as I lead you through Ashok Leyland's progress. You will come to discover that with every innovation, every product, our core philosophy from the very beginning has been that of Aapki Jeet, Hamari Jeet. In our stakeholders' success lies ours. To be by your side through your progress, through your success, 7 decades of enhancing lives through mobility. Post-independence, Raghunandan Saran helped Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru's dream of India becoming an industrial power come true. Ashok Motors was set up in 1948 to assemble Austin cars, and a year later, the first A40 was assembled. Mr. Saran had a larger vision though. He wanted to empower the whole nation by giving them access to mobility. He set in motion the wheels of a partnership that would change the course of India's automobile industry. A collaboration was set up between Ashok Motors and British Leyland to exclusively import, assemble and progressively manufacture trucks. In 1951, the first Leyland chassis was successfully assembled. After the establishment of the Ennore plant, Leyland Motors came in as an equity partner and Ashok Motors became Ashok Leyland in 1955. The Indian market immediately took to Ashok Leyland's Comet for its power, rigidity and fuel efficiency. With just 252 employees on board, 1,000 units were sold. By the turn of the second century, the company already had numerous industry firsts to its credit. The Comet bus followed that success in 1963, a passenger body built on a truck chassis. Right from the early days, the company's philosophy was all about catering to the needs and safety of its customers. An example of this is the introduction of the full air brakes for the first time ever in the Indian market. They also created an entirely new vertical of vehicles that were built for applications like mining, engineering, and construction. The launch of the Titan, India's first double-decker, wrapped up the second decade and set the foundations for a new phase of growth. The end of the decade also featured the first appearance of the Ashok Leyland flywheel that later goes on to be the company's identity. Thinking bigger meant broadening the horizon. Ashok Leyland expanded its manufacturing to the needs of the Indian Army in 1970, a relationship that turned into a long-standing one. In 1972, the company reached its mark of 10,000 vehicles manufactured in 1 year before completing 25 years in 1973, the year after which they exceeded a turnover of 100 crores. The company got a few more country firsts under its belt in its third decade of operation. Introduction of power steering for commercial vehicles, the Viking, the first Indian bus with an alternator and a unique front overhanging that facilitated front entry, the Cheetah, India's first rear engine bus, were a few amongst many more that were to come that set the stage for a large-scale expansion that was to follow. Before long, Ashok Leyland had made its presence felt across product segments. To keep pace with the growing demands of the business, Hosur One was set up in 1980 as an independent manufacturing unit and the company began to surge ahead with many more industry firsts, such as the vestibule bus in 1982 that gave a whole new meaning to urban travel. The expansion also gave way to the commissioning of the Bhandara plant in 1982, a gearbox specialist quickly followed by Alwar the same year, a dedicated passenger chassis unit that would cater to the northern markets. The company experienced a phenomenal growth spurt that caught the eyes of people around the world. In 1987, the Hinduja Group, a transnational conglomerate, took over Ashok Leyland as a major shareholder. 39 years after its inception, the company set out on a new journey. A journey that will see it spread its wings around the world. With new leadership, a new sense of purpose and fresh energy seeped into the company. In 1990, a dedicated technical center, the fifth unit of Ashok Leyland, was set up on the outskirts of Madras. It soon became the birthplace of numerous industry-changing designs. A year later, the company caught the eye of foreign investors. 1993 saw the company to be ISO 9002 certified, followed by ISO 9001 certification in 1995, the first Indian auto manufacturer to be granted one. Ashok Leyland's commitment to its consumers led to the setting up of the Drivers Training Institute in Namakkal, a first of its kind in the country, dedicated to helping not only aspiring drivers but also fleet owners. The company's expansion continued with Hosur too, which has a dedicated line for the manufacturing of army vehicles. The stallion resulted in Ashok Leyland being the largest logistics supplier for the Indian Army. The year 1997 was an especially eventful one for the company through the launches of India's first CNG buses. 1998 marked the completion of five monumental decades, a golden milestone for Ashok Leyland. The company's futuristic vision motivated it to develop cleaner and greener vehicles, launching India's first hybrid electric bus in 2002 and BS3 engines in 2005. The company's philosophy of Aap Ki Jeet, Hamari Jeet took to the stag being flagged off by the then Prime Minister, Dr. Manmohan Singh, and becoming the first bus ride into Pakistan from India. The company took another step out into the international market by being granted permission to set up a unit in Ras Al Khaimah, the only commercial vehicle manufacturer to have an assembly plant in the UAE, setting the tone for a decade of global expansion that was to follow. In 2010, the Pantnagar plant was set up with ultra-modern infrastructure and processes to make sure that the company's innovations kept up with the international needs in addition to the ones at home. With Mr. Dheeraj Hinduja taking the baton as the youngest chairperson of the company, Ashok Leyland further went on to introduce many industry firsts, such as the world's first front-engine fully flat floor bus, the Jan bus in 2012, India's first Euro 6 compliant truck, India's first rollover compliant school bus Sunshine with iAlert in the year of 2016. The company also focused on taking its green initiative forward by owning Optare as a subsidiary in the UK, which will be manufacturing the world's first zero emission electric double-decker for the London City bus fleet. Along with its global reach came global recognition. Ashok Leyland's world-class quality control was internationally recognized when the Pantnagar plant won the Deming Prize in 2016, followed by the Hosur plant receiving the honor in 2017. Over the decades, Ashok Leyland has also taken up an interest in giving back to the community through programs such as the Road to School and other green initiatives that help better the environment. The seven decades have seen the company grow from a car assembling unit to becoming a leader in the commercial vehicle sector, the 12th largest manufacturer of trucks worldwide, the 4th largest manufacturer of buses globally, the 2nd largest manufacturer of commercial vehicles in India. Through this journey, we have learned, among many things, the importance of giving back to society, the importance of Aap Ki Jeet, Hamari Jeet. Our products touch the lives of millions of people every day. And to us, these numbers are not just a measure of achievement, but a reminder of the responsibility that we hold towards the people we serve. As we turn 70, we salute the nation and its people for helping us reach where we are. We strive to continue touching lives and winning hearts in our way forward.